I don't know if any of you will have seen the programme that I'm going to be talking about here, but the issue remains, and I think it's something that most of us have thought about up to a point. I'm going to put a link in the sidebar to BBC's iPlayer. Somebody actually lost their account at YouTube over because they uploaded the programme. As you will see from the title, it's about paedophiles. And a guy called Louis Theroux, who is an extremely talented documentary maker. He seems to have a knack of drawing the best out of people and making it really interesting and quite down to earth and asking the sort of questions that a lot of other people wouldn't think to ask. But he was at a facility in California, not a prison, what called itself a hospital. Hugely expensive place to build, actually very lavish. The people were very comfortable there, and most of them were going to spend the rest of their lives there. There was a program for therapy and so on, but the majority of them refused to take that. But even if they did take it, there was no guarantee, because people wouldn't necessarily be able to get accommodation outside because nobody wanted them near them. There are several points for me, really. Firstly, the fact that there are very few things about which I'm judgmental. I can usually find my way to make sense of what lies behind people's reasons for doing things or being the way they are. I can be around the most difficult of people without it feeling troubled by it at all, or to have any negative feelings about the individual. You know, there are causes for most of the things that people do. But paedophilia is one of the very few things about which I cringe and find it extremely hard not to condemn the people involved, and kind of almost want them just to go away and never have to think about that kind of thing again, that kind of atrocity imposed upon a child. And I don't think it really helped watching the programme in the sense that I didn't feel particularly empathic in any way towards most of these people. They, though some of them gave the appearance of understanding that what they had done was wrong and harmful, they still didn't really seem to comprehend the consequences. And a lot of them even justified it and didn't see it as a particularly bad thing. But then again, you know, as I can even say in this circumstance, well, they probably had it done to them. I mean, the majority of people who abuse have been abused. But then there is the question, why do some people who have been abused not abuse? It's a complex issue. But, you know, this place was spending millions and millions. I think it cost something like £200,000 a year, dollars, to keep one person in this facility, and chances are that they were going to be there indefinitely until the day they died. In luxury, well cared for, offered all sorts of things that many people don't get. It was almost as if they were being rewarded for what they'd done. Of course, they didn't have their freedom, but it raised these kinds of questions for me, and it made me question myself in terms of, you know, what is it about this particular group of people that means there is a kind of barrier in me that makes it very hard for me to even listen to what they're saying, to see beyond, I guess. It's because, you know, it doesn't take a genius to work out that you shouldn't have sex with a child, that no child is in a position to consent to sex, and it will be, by its very nature, abusive. A child's body is not designed for it. anyway, and a child's mind certainly is not designed for it. Anyway, I'm curious as to what you, my friends and subscribers, and anyone who even who doesn't know me, thinks about this issue. It's a tough one, and I don't think there are any easy answers. But you know, any thoughts you have would be, you know, I think a good discussion on this might serve some useful purpose.